So why does God love us? This short question is among the most profound questions ever asked, and no human would ever be able to answer it sufficiently. But one thing is certain, however, God does not love us because we are lovable or because we deserve His love. If anything, the opposite is true. The state of mankind since the fall is one of rebellion and disobedience. Jeremiah 17:9 says, "The heart is deceitful above all things and desperately sick. Who can understand it?" So this describes man's inner condition. Our innermost beings are so corrupted by sin that even we don't realize the extent to which sin has tainted us. In our natural state, we do not seek God, we do not love God, we do not desire God. Romans 3:10 to 12 says, "As it is written, none is righteous, no, not one. No one understands, no one seeks for God. All have turned aside, together they have become worthless. No one does good, not even one." So this clearly presents the state of the natural, unregenerate person. There is none righteous, no, not one. How then is it possible for a holy, righteous, and perfect God to love such creatures? To understand this, we must understand something of the nature and character of God. And in order to do this, we can read this about this in 1 John chapter 4, verse 8, and also in 16, where it says, "Anyone who does not love God does not know God, because God is love." And when we read verse 16, it says, "So we have come to know and to believe the love that God has for us. God is love, and whoever abides in love abides in God, and God abides in him." So never was a more important declaration made than this: God is love. This is a profound statement. God doesn't just love, He is love. His nature and essence are love. Love permeates His very being and infuses all His other attributes, even His wrath and anger. Because God's very nature is love, He must demonstrate love, just as He must demonstrate all His attributes, because doing so glorifies Him. Glorifying God is the highest, the best, and the most noble of all acts. So naturally, glorifying Himself is what He must do, because He is the highest and the best, and He deserves all glory. Since it's God's essential nature to love, He demonstrates His love by lavishing it on undeserving people who are in rebellion against Him. God's love is not a sappy, sentimental, romantic feeling. Rather, it is agape love, the love of self-sacrifice. He demonstrates the sacrificial love by sending His Son to the cross to pay the penalty for our sins. As it says in 1 John 4:10, "In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that He loved us and sent His Son to be the propitiation for our sins by drawing us to Himself." Also, as it says in John 6:44, "No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up on the last day." And this is done by forgiving us of our rebellion against Him and by sending His Holy Spirit to dwell within us, thereby enabling us to love just as He loves. He did this in spite of the fact that we did not deserve it. But as it says in Romans 5:8, "But God demonstrates His own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." Praise the Lord. God's love is personal. He knows each of us individually and loves us personally. He is a mighty love that has no beginning and no end. It is this experiencing of God's love that distinguishes Christianity from all other religions. Why does God love us? It is because of who He is. God is love. Praise the Lord, and God bless you.